So hi guys, me again. Today my video is taking place in GM Construct Trains. As you can see, it's very nice map, nice model designed with smooth curves in the corners where you can easily achieve 110 km per hour using this maglev contraption here that I made. So here we have two of my maglev modules. I need to code controlling the speed to this contraption towards the x direction. One display for showing it its value and the display for displaying the control signal, which is applied to control this variable here. So for transition process that I'm gonna show you, I'm gonna use this oscilloscope. Some of you can ask, how are you controlling this oscilloscope? So here is my code. We have dots length, value range, scale for hour value, offset to the signal, time scale, time range. The difference between these two is that this one is scaled by the oscilloscope minus 1 plus 1, and this time scale is 0 seconds to 10 seconds. As 10 seconds is scaled for 1 and 0 seconds to minus 1. And here for the time we have integrator. And the Y is the scaled value that I'm showing. So I'm gonna show you how the transition process can be affected depending on the controller parameters you use. I'm going to start using unstable transition process, which neither of my colleagues automation engineers doesn't like. So update the A2 chip and set a little reference. We need for example 1, and if we hit space, we see the unstable transition process of the velocity towards the x-axis. As you can see, the amplitude of this thing grows exponentially. That's very bad, very bad. The next one is auto-oscillating. It's used in many objects controlled by relays or other things. For example, temperature objects and so on. It's not very useful, but it has better use for tuning pit controllers, as you measure amplitude for auto oscillating and the pit controller gain. So let's update the chip again. This should be okay. And hit space. The amplitude never changes. It's always the same. As you can see, this process variable, like our speed here, will never reach the reference, but oscillate over it. So enough of this. Let's try oscillating. This is oscillating process variable. Overshot and long time to reach the reference. In this case, amplitude slowly goes down while our controller doing its purpose. Let's try now short oscillating. Some reference and hit space. Come on. So our speed reaches the reference faster and with a little overshot. The difference between these two here is the short oscillating transition process gives the system more energy to reach the reference. We can see that using the controller parameters. Here we have 150 and here just 30. The integral turn is still the same. Here we have D part, dumping the power velocity. So more energy is better, but not always. We can make our object unstable using more energy than needed sometimes. So enough of the oscillating. Let's try a different thing. Pick controller with larger gain. Some reference and hit space. You can say, this transition process is very nice. But I'll tell you, this thing is a devil. So let's just say a big part of mass is connected to this thing here. If you hit space, the controller will calculate very large control signal, and this mass that is connected to this will probably off. To demonstrate it, I'm gonna use some model here. This one, for example, and we're gonna put it right here, and weld it to the maglev. So let's see how the Newton law will present our control signal. Oh my. Newton was right. So larger P control gain is not always the better choice. Because here, now our model is different. The mass center is high. And if we stop this pop here, this one will continue moving forward. So enough of this. Let's see different transition posts. Second transition process. I'm going. The next one I'm going to show you is the critical acrylic without toggle shot. Here is some reference. If we hit space, the reference is 0 kilometers per hour. But here we have some overshot, depending on the control parameters. And you can say, yeah, that's nice, that's smooth, but it's not that simple. Because if you, for example, are here with 100 kilometers per hour, and let's just say you want to stop right here. Yeah, our reference is here. So we're gonna stop here. But what if there is a wall here? Now it's not that simple, is it? You're gonna hit the wall with great speed, and that depend, and that leads to great impulse and great force. So the answer to all your problems is usually the simplest one: aperiodic transition process, which all of us automation engineers like. So let's give us some reference. 103 and space. That's pretty nice, I can say. Every automation engineer's transition process. Aperiodic one is always smartest, nicest. But in some plants you can achieve this, and you have to deal with it. Oh my. So that's my tutorial for you guys, how the transition process, depending on the controller parameters and how you can make your and control your plants with different transition processes, and see you next time.